Hello and welcome to UMG Philadelphia. My name is, of course, Benson. I am joined by the wonderful Gandhi. How you doing, bud?
I am awesome. Weather's a little bit cold. Just a little Hercules bit. Is showing that he is
that.
A big
I knew,
problem.
I knew you were going to bring that out.
I had to.
You had to.
It's a nor'easter for a reason. But you know what? We still have this place jam-packed here in Philly.
There is
barely any room to walk at all.
There's a lot of people that have come out this way, and you know, I don't blame these guys because the last couple of months, COD Esports has got, just a little bit more interesting. You know, we've had some team changes going on. The storylines going into this event now are absolutely insane. You know, there's a couple of matches that, you know, as casters are kind of sat there saying, you know, look in the bracket, well, if this and that happens, we could have some absolutely amazing games. But the first game, I'm pretty excited about. I'm not going to lie.
Yeah.
It's
going
to be Justice. And for me, fantastic team. Obviously, they placed third at MLG.
Yep.
And they're coming into this event looking so, so good.
Yeah. And on the other side, they're going to be playing Fuse. But before we get into that, I just want to say, in case anyone hasn't been paying attention to Call of Duty Esports at all, we have no team with the exact same roster coming from Columbus. We did see Complexity made a team change. They picked up Bilbo Baggins, a.k.a. Karma, as their fourth in place of Clayster. Clayster now finds himself on TK.
Did you just call Karma Bilbo Baggins?
Yeah, that's my joke with him.
Okay.
I mean, he's literally 5'4".
He is pretty
small. On a good day.
Although, luckily for him, his height doesn't affect his Call of Duty ability.
Yeah.
So, that's all good.
So, taking a look here at the bracket here. So, we do have 12 teams who are guaranteed already into the championship bracket. Those are going to be our top 12 seeds, obviously.
Yep.
With the remainder of the competitors competing for the four final slots. And Benson, who are you excited for? I'm going to get out of the way because you've been holding this.
Everyone from Europe, you're going to get excited because obviously you will know we have Team Orbit in the open bracket. Now, interesting fact, every single time a European team has come to an American event in the last couple of years, they have managed to progress through that bracket and got to that championship bracket.
Really?
So, I was speaking to the guys at Orbit. I was saying, look, I want to put you in my top three. I genuinely do believe you have the ability of coming here and causing some massive upsets. But the problem is, as we saw, you know, MLG Anaheim, for example, you know, both European teams managed to break out of the open bracket. They got into the champ bracket and immediately got taken out.
Yeah, they were just this close. I mean, TCM had a very, very good game against Complexity. I thought they kind of went to the nail with them. But I think the main thing that separates, you know, European teams in the open bracket compared to all the other amateur teams is just their unorthodox play style, right? Like, it catches a lot of the pro teams off, and they end up having to get used to that, you know, ability and how they play and everything like that. So, you know, you got to take that into consideration. But, you know, a couple of the other teams out here, we do have yet another Halo team with a couple other Halo
These
players
Halo guys.
Here. We have Final Boss, for those of you who have...
You're so excited.
Final Boss.
He has not stopped talking about Final Boss all day.
Well, you watched him play earlier, and they are shredding.
I'm not going to lie, they look good. They
well,
definitely
the thing that's exciting about Final Boss here, and we're going to be short and sweet on this, is Ogre 2 is the best FPS player of all time across any game. He has 39 event wins.
Pretty good little accolade to have there, really.
Yeah, he's
the best FPS player.
So I'm really looking forward to him. But, you know, we also have Fear. Fear has made the trip out here.
Right, yeah.
They do. We are going to see Moho and Dito.
I'm so excited about that.
Right?
I love watching Dito play. He's definitely one of my players that all the time you need to watch out for. He can go off at any time. Moho as well. So excited to see him here at UMG. Because, again, he's one of those players that can just turn it up, just click of a finger, and just cause some massive, massive upsets. And, you know, I think they should be coming here and feeling pretty confident, you know?
Yeah, they should be pretty, pretty good coming into here. I mean, we've seen they saw some success on the MLG Pro scrims. They saw some other success here and there. But I think it's just going to be good for them to kind of get their feet wet here on the tournament. They do have Formal, another Halo guy they picked up as their fourth. But really, Dito is kind of the star on this team. I mean, every time he plays, he's just...
He is very, very good. But, I mean, in terms of overall, who are you kind of looking at now after all these team changes that we've had? Obviously, we have storylines like, you know, what happens if TK play Envy, for example?
That's going to be
a great game. What happens if TK play Complexity as well? You know, all these fantastic storylines that come through. But in terms of your overall, what are you looking at? Like, which team are you looking at to really go and stand out the most?
Okay, well, I got two teams. And the first team I want to talk about is someone we all and everyone in the community knows and loves is, of course, Optic Gaming.
Of course.
They did part ways with JCAP, and they now acquired Ricky. Now, the reason why they picked up Ricky is because they wanted, like, a vocal leader in-game, and when they originally picked up Nature, they were like, oh, yeah, Nature can fill this, but it just didn't work out that way, so now they've acquired Ricky. Ricky is one heck of a player. He's very, very, very good.
So it's
going to be interesting to see how it goes. We do know that Big Timer's going to be retiring after this event.
Sad news.
The GOAT of COD finally parting ways, and he will be becoming
Guinness Book
the coach.
Of Records twice, apparently.
Yeah. So I think for me, I would just, it's kind of like that like heartwarming story. It's like, oh, his
you kinda
final
want, you
event.
You want them to go out
like,
on top, right?
he did awesome, right?
Yeah, he did.
And so that's Optic Gaming. On the other side, I want to see Complexity. Complexity is one of the only teams I know in the history of any game to go 7 out of 8 events and drop one of their main stars of their team due to a personality issue, and that's really what it came down to.
Yep.
So they picked up Karma, who is just, he's a monster.
Yeah,
right?
Let's be honest. If you're going to pick up anyone, Karma's a guy. you're going to pick up.
It's okay to pick up Karma.
Yeah, but I mean, you have to think, from Clayster's perspective, he sat there and he's thinking, we just won 7 out of 8 championships and I just got dropped. Like, how does that make sense? And obviously, he went straight to TK. Now, that TK lineup, they were running with Goonjar. Goonjar, he moved on to Team Envious. Now, you look at that new TK lineup. The last two events, they managed to finish second and they've been knocked out by Complexity both times.
Yeah.
Now, you take Clayster away from that Complexity team and you add him to that TK lineup, that team becomes so strong.
And the thing that's crazy about TK, too, is that, when they lost Goonjar, it was an easy fit-in for Clay,
right?
Because Clayster's like, oh, yeah, I run an AR. I play these exact same positions, bro.
Pretty convenient,
but
right?
But the one thing here, just from watching their streams a little bit, when they first picked up Clayster, the thing that was weird that for them to get used to is Clay is a very, very vocal guy. So when things
really?
Are going right, he's going to be like, what is happening? Why aren't you guys doing this? And I think that took a kind of caught him off guard just a little bit.
Right.
But, as the weeks progressed and he continued to play with them, I think they kind of caught that rhythm and they're looking good going into this event.
Yeah, I'm definitely looking forward to that. And I just hope we see TK versus Complexity and TK versus Envy. That would just be the storyline that I think everybody going into UMG Philadelphia is really wanting to see. Just the emotion that's going to come out of these players. It's going to be great to see, and I think that's something that has really lit up the COD esports scene in the last month or so. And I'm very, very excited. And you were mentioning about Optic Gaming a little bit earlier on. It's worth saying our sort of grand finale of the stream a little bit later on is going to be Optic Gaming going up against FaZe. What a way to end the first day here at UMG Philadelphia.
What a way to bring people in on the first night, too. I mean,
Optic versus FaZe, there's always been that massive rivalry between those two organizations. They've always been at each other. People always saying how, both teams very, very talented, very, very close matches always between those two.
Yep.
I mean, hit me with a prediction.
Optic and FaZe?
Yeah, I want to know exactly what you think, because my mentality going into that game is you have Big T. He's retiring after this event. He wants to go out on a high, let's be completely honest. You have all the guys at Optic desperate to bring home that championship for their fans, as well as that, you have Ricky. What a fantastic pickup he's been. You've seen Optic playing online looking so good. Then you talk about the FaZe lineup. I mean,
well,
they're so good as well.
But yeah, yes and no for me with the whole FaZe lineup. And the reason why is like when this team formed, because it was originally, instead of Methods and JCap, it was Enable and Ace.
Right?
And they were doing well online. And then they were like, oh, man, we need pro points. And so then it was like, oh, let's just grab JCap and let's grab Methods because that's the way to do things. So I don't know if it's like a placeholder team just so they could be in the champ bracket. I don't know how things went. Uh-huh. I know Methods and JCap had some clashing of schedules and stuff like that. So for the story, I'm going to go Optic, but I think it's going to be a good series.
All right. Well, we are going to be right back with you with the first game of UMG Philadelphia after this short commercial break.